Ladies and gentlemen, Steve Unger on the phone.
Hey, everybody. How you doing?
Hey, man. What's up?
I just sitting here with my family and friends, celebrating, enjoying a couple of drinks, and giving you a call, man.
Awesome, man. Thank you for the interview. I just have to tell you that, you know, you guys were just A-plus stellar when I was in Tacoma. You treated me like family, and that's stuff that you don't ever forget.
Yeah, well, that's what we're supposed to do, isn't it?
keep it in metal, man.
I expect the same treatment when I get down there, all right?
All right. You got it, man.
All right, it's a deal.
No, it was awesome. Your sons, what do they call, Sin Circus?
Yeah, Sin Circus.
Man, they kicked butt on that show, opening up for me, and they let us use the drum kit, and it was just killer.
Yeah, they are awesome, man. I got them they're playing shows all over the place up here in, you know, the Washington and Oregon area. And, yeah, they're just impressing me every day. You know, every time I get on stage and I watch them, I'm just like, man, I wish I was half that good when I was their age.
Yep, you're training them right. And they're getting it from the metal god himself. I love that,
yeah,
man.
Yeah, they've been rocking since the womb, so that's kind of where that sits.
Yeah, you can tell they're A number one good. So tell us about
that. This
video real quick before we get into Metal Church. Tell us about this video that you guys have planted.
The video that we're shooting for Spin Circus?
Yeah, you mentioned today on a little tweet about the goat and the midgets.
Right.
It sounds pretty freaky there, brother.
Well, you know, nothing with me can be, you know, that easy. What they're doing is they're shooting a video that is going to be played before they take the stage every day, or, you know, every show that they do. And the video is basically going to be them walking up, or not going to walk up, but they're going to be driving up in a limo, and, you know, the door is going to open to the limo. You know, a bunch of fog's going to roll out of it, and then we got about 8 or 9 hot chicks, you know, that are going to come popping out of it. And then we're going to have 3 clowns step out of it. And then we're going to have a couple of midgets jump out. And then we're going to toss a chicken out. And then we're going to toss a goat out. And then the band's going to step out.
Classic.
So basically, yeah, the idea is that, you know, the circus is now in town, you know, and here they are. And so the audience, from their perspective, they're going to see the band pulling up in a limo to the back of the building and the whole circus jumping out, chicken, goat, and all. And, you know, then they're going to have the video of them, you know, walking through the backstage and the road guys handing in their guitars and, you know, basically as they're all putting their fists together to go boom, of course the pyros will go off and they'll already actually be on stage and the curtain will drop and bam, they start their show.
Awesome. Awesome. Classic metal in the sense of, of the word.
Just, you know. Just trying to, you know, work all the angles with them and, you know, show off, you know, how big they got potential to be in.
Cool, man. Cool. Very cool. Well, I wish I had a dad like you. My dad was always telling me to go to school, be a doctor, be a lawyer.
Yeah, I heard the same thing. Cut your hair, would you, Jesus, kid? You know, you'll outgrow that one day. And, well, I still haven't, so I hope they follow my steps as far as that go.
No, that's awesome, man. So, okay, we got Metal Church, and, I mean, the response, I have to tell you, Steve, the response has been overwhelmingly positive. People love you guys.
Yeah, Metal Church has got a fan base that's just absolutely unbelievable. You know, it even overwhelms me sometimes, you know, and I mean, I joined the band in 2003, and, you know, every time you're like the new guy coming into an established band, you kind of got your, you know, you got to prove yourself, I guess. And, you know, I think that their fan base pretty much accepted me and kind of embraced me as being the bass player. And, you know, all I can say is thank you to everybody for that. I love being a part of Metal Church. All the guys in the band are awesome.
Yeah.
I've had some of the best, you know, I've had some of the best times of my life, you know, touring around the planet with these guys and, you know, playing in front of the incredible fan base that these guys got, and you know, I'm just so blessed to be a part of it, man. I, you know, that's really about all I can say.
Yeah, well, everybody seems to be supportive, excited, and it way into it. And it's one of the best responses that I've had so far with the show. And I've had some pretty big stars on the show. And, you know, the right away, everybody's just embracing you guys. And it's just awesome to see that and to be somewhat a part of it, you know. So you've got the original guitar player, Kurt, is back with the band. And how's he doing?
Yeah. Kurt's doing great, man. You know, we've all kind of been doing our own projects and such here on the side. You know, I've been busy working with my kids, you know, managing Sin Circus, playing also in Where Angels Suffer, which is, you know, all the guys from Wasp.
Yeah. Hot band.
What's that?
Hot band. I like it.
Oh, right on, man. I love them guys too, man. You know, that's another band that I'm just ecstatic to be a part of, man. I just, you know, I feel so lucky to be in like two of the coolest bands on the planet.
And it's metal.
and it's metal, yeah. You know, it's just, you know, these are the kind of things people dream about all their life, and I'm living it.
So was Jay Reynolds in the lineup before you, or you and Jay joined Metal Church at the same time?
Essentially, myself, Jay, and Ronnie Monroe all joined at the same time, within a week or so of each other.
Wow. Because, you know, when I asked you, I go, who's in the band? And you said you named off who was in the band. I knew that name, Jay Reynolds, sounded familiar, but I didn't realize who he was or where it was from until I read up on it, and it's like, oh, Jay from Malice, dude.
Jay's been around the block a few times, man. You know, again, Jay's a great guy, guitar player, and
you and him,
it's a better lineup. I can't ask for a better lineup.
Yeah, yeah. With you and him, I know it's metal. You know, there's no question in my mind. I think the audience and the people know that too, man. They're really digging it.
Right on. Well, I can't wait to get out and you know, play some shows, man. It's been a while, especially since, you know, Metal Church. I think we did our last show in 2009 at the Rocklahoma Festival.
Oh wow!
And you know,
cool.
That was our last show, and man, it's, you know, I always thought about the day that we were going to come back and do some kind of reunion thing, and you know, it's now upon us.
Here it is. So you guys are doing the cruise in January, and are you excited about that?
Is Frog's Ass watertight? I mean, come on, yeah.
I know, 70,000 tons of metal cruise, you know.
Yeah, how amazing is that?
Awesome.
Yeah, I mean, you know, most people are paying big bucks to go on this cruise. We're getting paid to go have fun.
I love it.
Yeah, so do I, man.
So that's January 28th through February the 1st.
Yeah, leaving Miami, Florida, going down through the islands, and it's got, what's it, 4 nights, 5 days?
Pretty crazy.
Yeah, yeah, and I guess we're doing 2 shows aboard the boat, and, you know, we're going to do some meet and greets and signings, and, you know, I guess we get to just kind of walk around with everybody that's partying and party right along with them, so I hope they're all ready, because I've been held up for a while here, so I'm ready to throw down.
You're going to throw down. I hear you.
Yeah. I hope the band and the fans are as well, man, because I'm a wild man on the loose right now.
The word has it that you guys have a surprise for the fans on this cruise. You're going to play the whole first album in its entirety? Is that true?
Well, now, if I told you that, I mean, it wouldn't be surprised.
Well, I want to be able to say that I broke the news, but... Man, that's pretty.
You heard it first here.
Yeah, that's pretty crazy, man. That's nuts. You know, I hope I can make it.
You know, we got a lot of things in store. I mean, you know, we've had a lot of time off, and I think everybody's kind of really excited and looking forward to getting back. And you know, I'm just this is just the tip of the iceberg, really. I mean, I'm hoping that you know, the fans totally embrace this comeback thing, and you know, something more can come of it than just a cruise.
So now, tell us about the last album that you guys did.
This Present Wasteland.
Cool. And when is that's still available, right? How do we get it?
Oh yeah. Oh, it's available. I mean, pretty much wherever you can buy a CD, I guess.
Yeah. And I mean, is the band have a website? What's the website?
You know, I know that when we threw in the towel back in 2009, the website kind of got abandoned, but I do believe that it is back up and running now.
Cool.
So if they Google Metal Church, it'll come up, or they'll get directed wherever they need to go.
I mean, people know how to Google their way around the planet, don't they?
Hopefully.
just look for us, Metal Church. You'll find us.
Yeah, yeah. That's awesome, man.
Yeah.
So, let's see, we've got the last album. Are you guys planning on maybe doing a new record, a new album? You think?
Well, there's some talk of us doing a live album.
Oh,
right
yeah.
Away.
Yeah.
So, you know, we'll see how it's all. I mean, right now, the only thing that I can tell you about is we're doing the 70,000 tons of metal. You know, and all I can tell you is that I hope that more things come of it, because it's something that I want to do. It's something that the band wants to do, and I guess it's, you know, really going to come down to the fans how they accept the band.
Yeah, you guys have been around for a while, man, and I'm my hat's off to you. You've been through, you know, a lot of ups, downs, you know, left turns, right turns. You know, death and tragedy, and the band has survived, and there's a lot to be said
for
that, man. You know,
somehow it's just managed to keep on moving forward, and you know,
yeah,
we're lucky for that.
Yeah, I love it. Well, man, want to shout out to you. Anybody you want to say hello to or pass the word on down here in L.A.?
Well, you know, just hello all my friends and fans down there. I know you. I'm looking forward to getting down there and seeing you all again and partying with you. So hope to come out and support the band when we get there.
Yeah,
for that matter, get on a plane, get on that boat with us. We'll party down for a week.
Yeah. Let me know, you know, if you guys plan a show down here, and, you know, we'll definitely get you back on the air or with the band or whatever we need to do, and we'll make it right for you, man, because I love you.
Right on, buddy. Love it too, man. That'd be awesome. Looking forward to it.
All right. Well, listen, man, thanks for your time. And, you know, maybe we'll see you on that cruise.
That would be awesome as well, man.
Cool. All right, man. Take care.
Bro.
Have a great weekend. And happy
Halloween. Take care, man.
Don't turn into no pumpkin or nothing.
I'll try not to, but.
All right, man. Take it
easy. Rock on, buddy.
Thank you.
Yep, see you, bud.
Bye. Ladies and gentlemen, Steve Unger from Metal Church. All right, we're going to play some Thin Lizzy for you. See if you can catch the name of this one.
This is a song called Suicide.